A show of opposition on the streets of Yangon after pro-democracy activists urged people to express their anger at Monday's military coup. Drivers honked horns and residents banged pots and pans, while others shouted their best wishes to detained political leaders, including Aung San Suu Kyi. Earlier, banks reopened and phone and internet services resumed, but this route to the city's international airport remained closed off. The military took power early on Monday, declaring a year-long state of emergency. It's already announced a major cabinet reshuffle, including the appointment of 11 new ministers and the sacking of 24 deputy ministers. Aung San Suu Kyi hasn't been seen since she was detained and is thought to be under house arrest at her official residence. It's understood that hundreds of members of parliament are being held in government housing in the capital.
It's very, very important that the generals be held accountable for this illegal action. And there's a range of options that the international community has. Those are being considered right now. There's lots of discussions going on. But we're going to move into the action phase, I hope, as quickly as possible.
The coup came after the army refused to accept November's election results, which gave Aung San Suu Kyi's party a landslide victory. It's accused her of fraud, but that's been denied by the Electoral Commission.